1 minute to run.
Okay.
The accident scene is a housing estate in the Pennine village of Mixenden.
Okay, let's have a very good look out for wires going into this one.
Okay.
Because the wire-rich environment. The FOD out to the right, that'll blow away.
Dr. Andy and his two paramedics are walking into a fraught situation.
Hello.
He's very upset. He won't let me fall.
Two motorbikes, one carrying a child, have collided.
They were just riding on motorbike and they've just gone into each other by accident. It was an accident, do you know what I mean? But it's scary, especially when he's only six.
Two adults and the six-year-old are badly hurt.
I'm not sure how fast they were going.
All the victims have suffered a major impact. The bikes came to rest 30 feet apart.
All right, Andy, keep your head still for us.
One of the adult riders, Andy, could have a spinal injury. It's vital he isn't moved.
Take a breath in for me. You got any pain in your chest or back?
It's on my back.
Or your back?
Paramedic AD must identify his young patient's injuries.
How much does your leg hurt?
Not bad.
Not bad. Can you move it? Can you do a kick with it?
No.
No, does it hurt too much to do a kick with it?
Yeah.
Okay. How about your other leg?
One underneath.
No, not all right.
Is that one all right?
The boy was wearing a helmet, but no other protection.
And then is it your finger that hurts? Yeah. All we could do is when he's ready, is get his helmet off, and then we can just make sure that he's not got any big injuries. We can give him some painkillers and just make him comfortable.
AD suspects his young patient may not be as well as first appears, but he's refusing painkilling drugs. The boy's stepdad, Daniel, was riding the bike. He's injured his leg.
He's six, isn't he?
Yeah, he's six, yeah.
The other adult rider, Andy, is going to be immobilised to protect his spine.
What we're
going to
do is roll you onto your back onto a stretcher, OK? When you're on the back, we'll have a little look at the rest of you and look at getting you some pain relief and things, OK? Can you move this arm at all?
It's numb.
That arm's numb.
The numbness, combined with his slow heart rate, could be the signs of a serious spinal injury.
I'm just concerned, given this numbness he's got, his bradycardia, whether he's going to have some neurogenic shock.
At least the six-year-old patient is stable. He's now agreed to have painkillers.
He seems OK for the moment. His colour's really good. Okay. I'm just giving him some Orem off.
OK.
Settle him down and we'll get to him and he's on with the leg.
Yeah.
Reinforcements are arriving just in time. On the estate, tempers are beginning to fray.
Right, and I rang Fiona. You don't need to have an attitude with me.
What an attitude.
Because I tell you what, you can just walk up here.
Guys, can we not have an argument? Can we not argue while we're trying to look after the thing?
Dr. Andy's patient is ready to fly. His symptoms are worrying.
OK, so this is important now, Andy. Can you feel me touching you there?
Yeah.
Is that normal?
Yeah, I can feel it.
How many out of 10 do you reckon that is?
I don't know, it feels like you're barely touching me.
Yeah, all right.
Hiya, mate.
Hello.
All
right.
Paramedic Al is going to take over the care of the boy.
So we're just waiting for him to settle, and then he might let us take the helmet off. At the moment, he's not letting us take the helmet off.
Until the helmet can be removed, they can't be sure whether or not the boy has also suffered a head injury.
All right.
Flying the kiddie to Leeds. Yeah. We're flying this one to Leeds.
Yeah.
Or the chap by road to Huddersfield, Halifax, wherever they go from.
Yeah, Bradford.
Police have been called in to keep the peace. It's feared the accident could lead to tensions in the community exploding.
There are still some potential quite serious injuries. The chap that we're dealing with, he's got a lot of pain in his back and he's numb from kind of halfway down his chest. And he's got a slow heart rate and that makes us really worried about a significant injury to his spinal cord. So we're treating him for that as best we can. We've immobilised him, we've given him some pain relief and we've made some arrangements to fly him to the major trauma centre. The other helicopter's here with some senior basics doctors, so they're managing the child. But at the moment, he's fully conscious, so that's good.
It's time to fly. Both choppers will be heading for the major trauma centre in Leeds, 15 miles away.
Lifting, reject back down to this spot if we need it, otherwise we'll carry on to LGI.
Okay, mate.
He's waiting for us, clear out to the right. Okay, let's look inside.
Yep.
I'll just go straight up from here.
It's been a difficult case for Dr. Andy.
If parents or relatives arrive, then obviously they're going to be quite emotional and upset, and you know, managing the parents and relatives is also another important part of the job, so it does make things a little more challenging.
His patient is continuing to show worrying signs of a spinal injury. A trauma team is awaiting his arrival on the hospital helipad. One wrong move could lead to paralysis, but their patient is more concerned with his uncomfortable surgical collar.
Andy, relax for me. Andy, relax. You're fine.
Okay.
Andy, listen to me. You're safe, all right? But we're worried you might have damaged your back. So the problem is, if you start moving around, you might make that injury worse. If you lift your head, that might do more damage. So just relax a little bit. Just let us move you downstairs. We'll have you in A&E. Then we get you off this hard board, all right? You'll be a lot more comfortable then.
Their patient will be taken for x-rays and scans within minutes of his arrival. The results could change his life.
Only injury appears to be an isolated back injury. He's got pain over the left scapula and pain mid sort of to lower thoracic spine. He's got normal sensation down to about T8, and then it's 2 out of 10 below that.
The six-year-old boy has arrived in the next cubicle. He may have to live with the effects of the crash forever. The six-year-old boy, flown to hospital after a freak bike crash, had a hairline crack to his kneecap, but was otherwise unhurt. But one of the adult riders needed surgery after he was found to have cracked 2 vertebrae in his spine.